Alright, I missed the opening tee shot. So Karl missed the fairway right off the tee. He's behind the bush on the first hole here. Looked to have had an unimpeded shot. Don't see it. That's not his ball on the green. I think he might have gone long. I think Karl might have got a stone caught between the ball and his club face with that second shot that he played, because he's gone a good 50 yards through the back of the green. It's going to take a heck of a up and down. See what he's done here. He's played that about as well as he could have. With putter in hand. It's very makeable. It's going to break from his left to right. Well, it's going to open with a bogey. Looks like he's either missing the fairway right or close to it. We'll see when we get up there. Oh, there it is down there next to the cart. Let's have a bit of tree action in front of him there. Sometimes it can just take a few holes to calibrate the driver. Let's hope that this first and second hole is all it's going to take today. Well, Karl's got an iron in hand. Probably around 200 plus yards out. So I'm not sure if he has a shot of the green here, because he does have a shrub directly in front of him. Let's see how we go here. Carl seems happy with this. As he should do, he's on the green, putting for birdie, albeit a long one. You take that from where he put his tee shot. Although a par 5 for the members, it's a par 4 this week for the tournament. 526 yards. Not quite in the hole yet. I forgot to push the red button there. Anyway, Karl missed his second shot left of the green. So obviously the ball was slightly above his feet and he's ended up drawing it a touch. The grass around the greens is cut down pretty low. So this shot's makeable. It's gonna be more about the speed than the break. If you get the speed right, whatever break you've read will apply. Good speed. Yeah, really good. So that'll be a 4, so that's bogey, par, par start for Karl. And all I've got to do now is remember to hit the red button when Carl's executing a shot. and we'll get them on video. Right, now I'm 140 yards away here.
Oh, yes.
There's a good shot by Nate onto the green there. And I don't have the digital zoom on. I've got the optical zoom, which might not mean much to a lot of you. It just means that this is as far as I can zoom. Whereas if I had it on digital, I could zoom another 200, 300, 400, 500 yards. Carl's probably got a pitching wedge in his hand. Seems happy with it. Yep, got an uphill putt for Bert. He's on the right side of the flag there because you can't see it for the contours here, but if you're on the right hand side of the flag here and you go a touch long, it falls down that hill to where Carl's ball is on the left there. Chance in 10 of making this. Now's a good chance to make it. Oh, he did too. Well done. Gets him back to square.
And that didn't just fall in, he hit it in the center of the cup.
So here we go, folks, for these players today, 380 yards, less than driver off the tee, so that they're leaving themselves with a wedge into the green. That's a hybrid card sit there. Likes it. Putting for birdie again. Oh, another one. Back to back. He likes that length. Right, big boy par 4, 481 yards. One of the advantages of playing desert golf is that that's not water. This is all guesstimation here on Carl's part, because he can't physically, visually see the green.
Thank you.
He's just asking his fellow players if they could keep an eye on where this finishes. Looks like he's going to go one extra club. Slightly into the breeze. Yeah, swing speed with his drivers, very quick. It's over 120 for sure. Good contact. Has he hit it far enough? Can can't see whether it's caught the bunker or whether it's on the green. Chance of saving par here. A couple of holes back, he was a good 15 feet off and he used his putter. But if there's divots between him and the hole, he can't use the putter. So that's the way, he's just going to have to drop it past those European divots. I don't know how on earth they've managed to be there. Maybe animal. Animals digging something, you know, we'll see. Yeah, nice effort. So it's a 5, which is a bogey, which takes him back to even par. Par 3, I'm up around the back of the green again in the best position for the sun, which I think you'll see when we look down onto the green here. We're just not looking into the sun, makes an enormous difference. Again, I'm on optical zoom rather than digital zoom, so this is that's as far as I can zoom in from here, but where I find my glasses, which I think I left in the car, I'll switch it back to digital zoom so we can get a lot closer without needing to get closer, if that makes any sense. I was happy with it, so let's zoom into here and go on, roll down. Well, Mike Thorbjornsson just had the exact same putt. And it's not as fast down that hill as it looks. Okay, Karl with around, I guess, 15, 18 feet. If he makes it, he'll tell me it was tall. Get out of Nate's way. From the same spot like Thorbjornsson, and also ran out of juice as it got close to the hole. Yeah, 8th hole, par 5, 617. Righty, 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 righty. 8th hole. Slowed down on that driver swing after missing the fairway badly on the last hole. And I think he just chucked himself out of sync there. He's only hit, I think, one or two fairways this front nine. Boy, oh boy, Karl was dancing with death there. That's why I think after he hit it, he thought he had rinsed it. But all is well now, life is good again. He's only got iron in hand on a 617-yard hole, so he's obviously planning to lay up and take the water right out of play. Otherwise, if you cut your 3-wood in an effort to go for it, this is what is there waiting for you miss. Now the key to playing these layup shots is to actually have a target. Not just a general area, but have an exact target. Small targets, small misses. Good swing. Would be a 4-iron. So he's just going to have a little flip wedge into the green there now. Well, Karl's disgusted with it, but he's got a 25 foot uphill putt for birdie. It's a problem when you get too close to the green, you're not coming in with a normal swing speed. And that was only a half swing, probably 80 yards. But I think he was just a bit too close. In the next two rounds, I hope he gives himself a three-quarter swing instead of that half swing. Players can, the closer you get to a full swing or normal swing with your wedge, the better the players are able to manage their yards, their yardages. So they just don't practice those half wedges as much as they do their full wedges. Two putts from this distance so far, this 9. See if we can make another. Perfect speed. Really good speed. Gonna have to settle for a par though. It is a long par 5. 619 yards, so there's no crime. That ninth hole. You can read it better than I can. 359 yards today. Karl could use driver, but driver hasn't been behaving itself, so he's going to be hitting his 3 hybrid. These clubs have been good. Carl's just a wedge in his hand, should land this about 6 feet shy of the flag. Just like that. Didn't risk going over the back. What am I even aiming at here? Oh, there we are. I've got to get the glasses from the car as I waltz over to the 10th. This is the 9th. Draw, you mongrel. He loves the 30 footers.